Hello, welcome to the News Digest this week. I am Vivian Kamsimi and we are discussing families. It is the Christmas season and we are spending a lot of time with family. It is time to celebrate family. Specifically, we are talking single parenthood. With me is Mrs. Ruth Muguta from the Ministry of Gender. Now, Ruth, we are spending a lot of time with families during this season. And single parenthood in families has been on the rise. During the president's speech in the Thanksgiving service, he talked about the importance of building families. How is government tackling this?
Thank you very much. I'm Tsasi Ruth Muguta, as you said. I'm a principal social development officer in the family unit. And Merry Christmas. We are all seeing as to see how we can join each other as families and how we can benefit out of this. As a government, it is our mandate. It comes from the Constitution, Objective 19, that family is the first unit in the society and it has the parliament or the government has to protect it. And during protection means to develop laws, policies, guidelines and standards to ensure that the family is stable and it benefits its members. It further goes to say that it is a man and a woman who finds at the age of 18 to find a family. So a family to Uganda is a social group that is made up of two people, the man and the woman, and this is very strict. A man and a woman, we don't approve of other families, and these ones either by they have their own children or they have adopted their children under extended families. And the most families that we know in Uganda is the smaller family, which is a nuclear family, and the extended family. And as you brought out, single family becomes part of those. It can be a single family, single-headed family, due to situations. But this situation doesn't mean that this family has lost its value as a family. Maybe they have lost a father or a mother because of death or separation or other situations. Someone decides which has come up. It can be child-headed family. You are talking of single families. We've seen due to the HIV, AIDS and other disasters that we have child-headed families. So all these, it is our role as government, especially Ministry of Gender, on behalf of the state, to ensure that we develop legal frameworks that protect the unit of the family.
Is this a problem?
Moderator, one of the indicator to indicate that the country is having a challenge with the family is one of that. Formally or traditionally, we used to have single parents, and especially because of death. But the family, because of the social networks, you would not know that either woman or that man would be able to be accommodated within the extended family and they take care. What has come up now, maybe due to economic constraints, due to psychological problems, you find that if I'm a widow, I'm left alone to take care of my children. If I get pregnant before marriage, I'm taken as an outcast. And so even I can decide to be a single parent, get pregnant, get my child. But all these come as an indicator of lack of trust within the family and extended family, and what the family as model families are showing the children that they are grooming. And we usually do things we see in our families is what we do and how we are groomed and parented and nurtured, how it mostly happens to other coming up families from their siblings.
Is it time to sound the alarm on single parenthood in the country?
If I had the authority, we would. Because one, there are so many disadvantages than advantages in growing up in a single parenting or single family. One, it impacts on you as a parent. Most of the stressed parents who are depressed and having challenges are single parents because you have no one to share with. Even it is biblical, God saw that Adam would not be alone and had to create a partner so that they can be able to be together, discuss together, and be able to resolve things if there are some misunderstandings. So as an individual, you are not an individual that you are alone. You have either a child or you have people who are attached to you or who are dependent to you, and you may get challenges. Whom are you going to discuss with? And this one has even grown up things like incest. The children get attached to the parent who is available, and most of them become, certain things come up. There is also lack of proper parenting if you are a single parent and you are not guided. Because especially if they are developed by, they are nurtured by a mother, usually the girls fail to decide because they are not balanced. The boys become too womanish. And so all this, but old parents or traditional or now even researchers have indicated if you get a male figure or a female figure within the lives of these children, it helps them to balance. It doesn't necessarily that you have to remarry, but others maybe that's why they do remarry, in order to balance up what God put there and what you may not give the other side of the male figure or the gender figure gives to this child. Especially, we are now in the era of where girls have gone astray. We are getting teenage pregnancies. The girls have looked for love somewhere. They have lacked information. We've lacked time for our children. Take an example, I'm a single parent and I'm working. If I leave home, who remains home with the children? None. If I come home tired, if I would be having another person and I'm come home tired, another one maybe would pay attention to the children's needs. And so this one becomes a challenge. That's why we usually advise them have a certain gender which you are not to balance up. For the girls, they lose love.
This is a very wide topic that we cannot exhaust in this single segment. Kindly do join us next week for the second episode. For now, do enjoy your Christmas and happy holiday season.